next, we salute those who have served in the Army.
Over hill, over dale, we shall hit the dusty trail, and those caissons go rolling along.
Peter Rison, past commander of Post 216 right here in Mount Bethel, the Portland Mount Bethel Memorial Post. I served in Korea. Well, supposedly it was peacetime, but where they sent us was up to the DMZ, and there was fighting continuously. Even though it was peacetime, I had my share, and the foxhole got quite busy. If I had to go and fight again, I would at a moment's notice, although I'm a little on the obsolete now.
Nelson of Mount Bethel Township. I am. U.S. Air Force, 1970 to 1974, to the hour. I served over in Southeast Asia. Main base was Taiwan, but I got around a bit. I came back stateside, and I was stationed on a site outside of Offutt Air Force Base. Communications, ground air communications. I guess the most vivid memory, truthfully, was when I had to carry body bags off an airplane. And the best memory was probably coming stateside and putting my feet on the North American continent.
And to keep our honor green, we are proud to claim the title of United States.
I'm Dwight Jones. Well, I live down near Martins Creek, but I'm a member of Post 216, American Legion. Well, I went in the Army in 1963. I spent most of my time in Germany. I was sent back early to train troops for Vietnam, and then in 66 I got back out of the service. And I've been with the American Legion now for 33 years. I was stationed in Germany, mountaintop in Germany. Met a lot of interesting people, and I got to go to interesting places.
John Krebs, and I served in the 3rd Armored Division in the Army during 1963 to 1970, but I didn't see no action because the President wouldn't let us go over to Vietnam. I was stationed at Fort Dix. I live in Wing Gap, Pennsylvania.
And what is your fondest memory of your time in service?
Thomas' memory was actually you're after this, working in the KP.
U.S. Navy, I'm Gary Brohl, B-R-O-E-H-L. I am from Mount Pocono, Pennsylvania. I served in the U.S. Navy from 1958 to 1962. I was on the USS Toga out of Mayport, Florida.
America, starting with Stars and Stripes Forever.
John Birmingham with the Board of Supervisors in Upper Mount Bethel Township, and we're having our Veterans Day celebration up at our community park. This whole event was sponsored by Lamtech and Custom Laminating, so I want to thank them so much, and John and Peggy Post and all they've done for our township. We thank you, and most of all, we thank our veterans, because that's here who we're honoring today. So all you veterans out there, thank you for your service. Thank you for protecting our freedom. We're going to have singers, we're going to have speakers, and then we're going to have fireworks and celebrate living in the greatest country in the world.
It's a grand old flag.
Jim Steele, First Assistant Fire Chief of Portland Hook and Ladder.
Okay, you guys brought the flag.
We did. Our ladies auxiliary got it for us a few years ago. It's 20 feet by 30 feet. Oh, it always gets a lot of comments, and people seem to like it. And yeah, we always get an awful lot of positive feedback.
Where there's never a
to veterans because they are special to all to us. We say thank you for your service.
I roamed and rambled, I followed my footsteps in the sparkling sands of her diamond deserts. And all
okay, hi, I'm Kathleen Connington, and this is my husband Neil sitting next to me. And we are part of the 153rd Pennsylvania Volunteer Infantry, a Civil War reenacting group that portrays the original 153rd Pennsylvania Volunteer Infantry, who were actually recruited out of Northampton County, and many of the men in Upper Mount Bethel actually served with the 153rd. So, and we're actually from Bath, which was another area where many of the soldiers came from, the Bath and area, and so any part of Northampton County was actually part of, many of them were part of this unit.
993 soldiers in Newton. We lost about, 78 men and one officer, so a lot of them survived the war. There were several that were discharged because of health reasons or were sick and discharged.
Wild, the Congresswoman for Pennsylvania 7, including Upper Mount Bethel. I'm just happy to be here. Veterans are very near and dear to my heart. My father was one. He spent his entire adult life in the military, got care at veterans hospitals around the country and around the world. And so, I will always stand with our troops, with military families, and I'm just delighted to be here on this gorgeous evening in Upper Mount Bethel.
Senator Mario Scavello, the 40th Senate District, Monroe and Northampton County. Oh, this is a way of recognizing those individuals that put their life on the line to give us the freedoms that we have today. And personally, it shouldn't be just one day. Every time we see a vet, go over to the veteran, shake his hand, and thank him for his service. And I make a point of that every day. It's always a busy day, and we're also on the 11th, which is the official Veterans Day. I have about five or so events, and I go to veteran organizations. They all have events, and we recognize them all and those that are there, and the comrades that are not there. Today we were up in Tobyhanna Township at the cemetery there. And we put wreaths on each and every one of the veterans' graves.
I'm the community school director out of the Bangor Area School District. I know some of your faces as you pulled in. I don't know everybody, but this is a really, really special time of year for us, for me personally. And it's my all-time favorite event that we usually hold out of the school with DeFranco Elementary School. And this year, with everything happening, we couldn't have it. So I was devastated that we were not going to be able to honor the veterans like we normally do. And I belong on a panel with John, and when he mentioned he was doing this, I jumped on it immediately and I said, is there any way that I can participate, that we can be part of it somehow? Because it's just so special to me, and it's so important for me, especially for our students out of the schools, to understand, because it gets lost, and it humbles me every year to see 50 plus veterans come together and just interact with one another, and a time for them to find joy at a time that they should be finding joy, that it was not always joyful for them. So it's really important for me. So thank you very much, John, for letting me be included in this. The boutonnieres were donated by JC Bloom Designs in Rosetto. She does it every year for us, and she says thank you as well. But I just thank you all so much. John, thank you for this. This is fantastic. I'm moved, and I'm glad my children were able to be a part of this evening.
As of today, is now the Chris Lubera Pavilion. Chris was a member of our road crew. He was a resident of Upper Mount Bethel, and his love for the park spread on to all of us and got us all to really love what we have up here. It was Chris Lubert's love of the park. He came up here every day, would look after the park, make sure that everything was in place, that the park looked as beautiful as it does today. So to the Lubert family, I want to thank you all for being here tonight. I want to thank Chris Lubert for the service that he gave to Upper Mount Bethel Township, and the pavilion is now named the Chris Lubert Pavilion. Thank you.
Land that I love, stand beside her and guide her through the night with a light from above.
So the dedication of our flagpole right behind there, it's a little dark, you'll see it when the fireworks go off. The flagpole, well, first I want to thank Matt Frangos, the Eagle Scout, for putting this together. He did this. He also, when you go up and see the flagpole, all the foundation around it was done by Matt. So it was his Eagle Scout project. So thank you, Matt, for that. As of today, we are naming the flagpole in name of Andrew Nestor Jr. Did I get that right? Yeah, okay. Andrew Nestor, I met Andrew a couple of times. He gave me a lot of knowledge of what it takes to be a supervisor, helped me out when I first thought about running. Andy was a member of the Navy. He was a member of our military, a veteran, and was also a supervisor here in Upper Mount Bethel Township for many years. And we have this plaque. It's going to go up by our flagpole. But as of today, our flagpole is now the Andy Nestor Jr. flagpole.
Thank you so much.